Alright guys, so last night I was doing a bit of testing with the fighters and stuff, and there is some concerns I have with them. I mean, first of all, we're just going to look at the Gladius here. So, from what I can tell, the pitch and the yaw feels good, but look at this. Look how quick that roll is. I mean, should it be like that? It just feels like I haven't got control, really, especially when dogfighting and stuff. I mean, if I go into my dogfighting mode right now, which is decoupled, and then bring the thrust down. But, like, if I'm making maneuvers, I just don't feel like I'm in control of the ship. I mean, it is a lot harder to aim and stuff whenever I am making these maneuvers, especially since I am the type of pilot who likes to roll a lot. So, I mean, trying to snap on the targets like this, it just feels very uncontrollable for me. I don't know if this is intended or, I don't know, maybe it does need tweaked a bit, but I just feel like it does need a wee bit of work. Like, it's just too quick. But we'll stop right there a second, because I just want to show you my curves. Let's see, where are we? Controls. Is it in controls? Oh, I'm most okay, there we go. Flight moving, okay, so if you look at my roll, I've actually stuck it up to max because I find it so twitchy. I mean, you can see yourself, like, that's on 3. Like, that's on 3.0. And my roll is still insane. Like, I'm only touching it and not even, you know, I'm not giving it full whack to the left or right. It's just a small touch. Look how twitchy it is. You know, I don't think that feels natural. And I mean, I do have this ship in game myself. Like, you know, I really like the ship. I've been flying it for, I don't know, a good few years. And even if I do melt it, I always go back to it because I just love the feel of it. Like, it just feels like I'm in a Hawk T1, you know? But yeah, that's what I think about the Gladius. It's just everything else, it feels lovely, but it's just that roll. I think there's like a, I don't know, it's sort of like sensitivity wise on the roll. It just doesn't feel nice. As I said, I don't know if it's intended or maybe CIG does need to tweak it a bit, but that's how I feel about the Gladius. Moving on to the arrow. Pitch and yaw seems nice, but if you look again, look at that roll. Like, how are you meant to control that shit? Especially when dogfighting, I mean, you cannot get that precision. There's no chance, unless you're a Twitch shooter. I mean, I'm not a Twitch shooter, that is not my playstyle. And I know CIG is trying to move away from that, but, you know, just like the Gladius, the roll is just far, far, far too twitchy. I mean, I'll go into my dogfight mode again, decoupled. That's what I'm saying, it just feels very twitchy. I mean, accuracy wise, you've got no hope of trying to get your target. To say, my curves are the same, I haven't changed anything. I'm still on max roll because this is just insane. Okay, so now moving on to the 300i, and what I can tell, yeah, pitch and yaw seems quite nice, but look, watch this. Far more controllable. This is what I think the Gladius and Arrow should behave like. Maybe a tad bit quicker, but this just feels much more natural, and I think this is what the Arrow and Gladius should be intended to be. See, this is a light fighter as well. My curves have not changed, but you can already see the big difference. It just seems more natural and more controllable to fly, especially when rolling. take it down a bit here. Going to decoupled. Yeah, like, I mean, it's far, far, far more controllable, especially for trying to get them pot shots. The roll just seems lovely on this thing. Far, far, far more controllable. But yeah, as I say, I think the arrow and the Gladius do need tweaked on a roll. I don't know, as I say, I'm not too sure if it is intended, but I mean, from flying him, it just doesn't feel nice to fly at the minute. I mean, I feel more comfortable in a medium fighter now because it just feels a lot nicer to handle. I don't know what it is, but the 300i feels like the ship to go to at the minute, especially for the light fighter style. Okay, so now moving on to the Sabre. Now, I know people are going to be like, yo, 2-tab, what are you doing? Like, this is not a light fighter, it's a stealth fighter. But characteristics, it behaves like a light fighter, even though it does have the weapons of maybe coming up to a medium fighter. But whenever you're debating what type of fighter it is, you always go by the flight mechanics, you know. So for fail, pitch and yaw feels nice. But again, I just want to touch on roll, because if you watch, look at the delay from completing the moves. I mean, it starts off slow and then gets faster, but then whenever I stop, there's like a 2-second delay before it actually completes the move. So it's like a kind of an overshoot, I would say, or like an oversteer if you were driving the car, I suppose. It's a lot easier flying this than it would be, say, the Arrow or the Gladius, but I mean, it's still got that overshoot. So say if I wanted, if I'm gonna pitch my cockpit to the top of this rock, it just, you know, I need to like stop before I actually wanted to hit that position. But it's just like a lot of overshoot on the roll. So trying to control this in the dogfight, especially up close in combat, it is kind of tricky. But speed wise, yeah, it does feel alright, to be honest. It's just, I think it's just that overshoot delay I'm not really keen on. But, and again, this is all just my personal preference, you know. It's, people may like it, fair enough, it's up to you, but for me, it's just, needs a wee bit of work, I think. Okay, so we're jumping to a Hawk. I actually haven't flown this in 3.5 yet, believe it or not. Excuse me. But I thought, yeah, why not, it's a light fighter, I might as well jump in, see what it's like. Okay, so off the bat, pitch off is nice, roll is lovely, oh my god. Far more controllable in this thing. Like, just know that like my curves have not changed whatsoever, so everything you've seen, I'm using the same, but this here just feels amazing. Like, it's not twitchy, it's just fluent the whole way through, which I think all ships should be. Should all be fluent. I'm like, I'm not a big fan of the Hawk, but flight wise is lovely. Much more control in this thing. I would actually consider picking one of these things up, just the way it flies. But yeah, as I say, I mean, I think the ship most of the ships do need a wee bit of rework in some way from the flight mechanics. I mean, some have obviously, there has been a post on Spectrum about ships having overshoots and stuff like that, and I'm pretty sure that CIT knows about it, but it's just at the minute I just want to show people like my point of view, really, you know, on how the ship should handle and stuff, and maybe we can get a comparison and stuff as well with other ships, which is what I'm trying to do here, you know, how I feel that they should react to compared to another ship, like say for the 300i for example. I think the Arrow and the Gladius should behave similar to it, maybe a wee bit quicker from being a military vessel, but as I say, they are far too twitchy, and they do need to be more fluent rather than snappy, you know, as well, is what I'm trying to get at. But overall, the Hawk feels amazing. I just want to thank everyone for taking the time to watch the video. I also just want to thank CIG for doing a fantastic job on the flight model. I mean, I'm going to show you a quick clip here of me just flying about shooting stuff because I'm really enjoying myself so far. You know, you guys are working so hard on this, and I think we do all appreciate what you're doing. Yeah, it may take a wee bit longer than we would like, but I mean, look at the results, they're just paying off.